Hello, today is day two of my video challenge, and I thought I'd try talking about my experiences with fasting in this video. When I talk about fasting, most of the time I think about it as a water fast, as it not having anything but only water. And one of the main reasons I got so interested in fasting was after reading the book How and When to Be Your Own Doctor by Dr. Isabel Mosher. She really talks about fasting in great detail, and every time I read that book, that particular chapter on fasting, it actually makes me want to fast, like a longer fast. And the other book that also inspired me to take on more fasting was the book Obesity Code, and the follow-up book The Diabetes Code by Dr. Jason Fung. So now coming to fasting, what are the benefits of fasting? The book talks about a lot of them. Basically, it's the time when the body, because it does not have to spend any calories or any energy on digestion, it pretty much uses all the energy it has, that difference of energy not spent on digestion. It uses all of that to cleaning itself, detoxifying, removing the dead cells and the waste proteins, all the products of metabolism and things like that. And it uses that to actually rebuild organs and regenerate organs. This will typically happen on a longer fast, usually like more than a few days long. So fasting helps the body in healing. But a lot of that is, I guess, textbook knowledge. And one of the things she says is that you have to actually do the fasting yourself to realize how powerful it is and what a difference it can make. My own personal experiences with fasting, again, these are like longer fasts, more than 24-hour fasts. I started back in 2009, shortly after reading this book by Dr. Isabel Mosher. I started with a 6-day master cleanse, which was essentially only taking a lemon juice mixed with maple syrup, sort of like a shikanji drink, having that like 4 or 5 times a day. And I did that for 6 days. For that first fast, I did not actually lose any weight. Probably because I was drinking so much sugar, now that I think about it, in terms of the maple syrup that was added. But I did follow up with the salt water flushing for the detoxification. So I did the daily salt water flushing. Did not lose weight. But second one that I did was a 5-day water fast followed by a 5-day juice fast. So I broke the water fast by having some juice, and then I continued that for another 5 days. And in that fast, I lost about almost like 10 pounds. Almost 10 pounds, and I lost those 10 pounds again in the first 5 days of water fasting. And once I started having juice fast again, I did not really lose any weight. And then I did 6 days in 2013 in March. And again, for those 6 days, I did water fasting, no food, only water. And I lost about 10 pounds in those 6 days. And then I did an 8-9 day juice fast in 2016. And when I say juice fast, I was actually having like only once or maybe once or twice a day juice. Usually in juice fast, they say that you can take up to 4 liters of juice also. I was taking maybe like 1 or 2 glasses, so like half a liter a day. And then there were some days in between where it was just water fast. And I did that for about 9 days. And in that whole period, again, I lost about, like 7-8 pounds. And then the most recent long fast I did was for 6 days in October of 2018. And again, in those 6 days, I lost about 11-12 pounds. So this is my history with these longer fasts. And typically, after these fasts, I almost gained back all the weight that I had lost in about 2 to 3 weeks. So these fasts were helpful, I think, in terms of helping me heal, like maybe cleared up little infections and things like that. Because one of the things I remembered, like after these longer fasts, was that like my sinuses would feel so clean, and I definitely felt like the skin of my face was much softer, and probably like the eyes were whiter. So there are definite gains that I got from fasting for these periods of 6 to 8 to 10 days. The weight that I lost, as I said, eventually came back. So I think the weight loss was not a long-term benefit that I got from fasting. And this is where I think the other book, The Obesity Code, and the follow-up book, The Diabetes Code by Dr. Jason Fung, that was the other book that actually made a big difference on how I think about fasting and how I approach fasting. Because part of my dissatisfaction with fasting was the fact that the weight would always come back. And Dr. Fung's books helped me realize that the weight actually is controlled by hormones. So depending on what the balance of hormones is in the body, the weight is going to be controlled by that. And once the fast ended and I was back to eating the normal amount of food and the normal types of food, I guess my hormones pretty much balanced around the point they were before the fast. So it's no wonder that the weight came back. It kind of made a lot of sense. So I read Dr. Fung's book back in October 2020. And that was the point, actually, I realized that I had to make some permanent and long-term changes in the way I eat food, how much and when. That would probably have more of an impact in helping me maintain the weight I wanted. And the long-term fasting is actually a powerful tool for healing the body, for helping it rejuvenate, for helping it rebuild organs and tissues. But that is not the best way to lose weight and keep it off. So that was my, like, one of the things that I really, you know, helped me appreciate fasting even more, that you have these longer fasts which can really help the body heal. So they are a tool for that. But to maintain a low weight or a target weight or a healthy weight, I will have to make sure that I eat in a way that keeps my hormones at that level, which helps keep the weight off. So I will talk about hormones, and especially the role of insulin in another video. I'm thinking of that tomorrow or day after. I'm doing 10 days of video. So I will follow up on that in the next one. The other thing I wanted to talk about fasting is that even though I grew up in India and fasting is a big part of the culture. My grandparents on my father's side, they both actually, from since the time I remember, they would actually never eat in the evening, like after sunset, they would not eat or drink water, and they did that for I think like 20, 25 years that I know of. Eventually, they did not adhere to it very strictly once they got into their 70s and 80s, just so that they had a option to take some medicine or something at night. But so because it was for religious reasons, so they were pretty strict about it. My grandmother on my mother's side also, she I think was did not eat anything after sunset. And actually, she for several years did what is now called the alternate day fasting, which in which you only eat on one day, and the next day is pretty much all water fasting, and then you eat the day after that. So you don't eat every day, but only on alternate days. In Jainism, we also have these actually 8-day fasts, which are done during a period called Paryushan. And I know many members of my family, lot of uncles, aunts, cousins, they've all done that at least once or twice so far. So fasting, even though it was part of the Indian culture and I saw a lot of that growing up, I guess I didn't really appreciate it. I just, because I didn't know how powerful it was in helping the body heal. And I guess for me, part of the reason of appreciating something is if I can see its utility, and health is a big value for me. If I cannot appreciate the advantages or the benefits, I am a little bit of a skeptic of doing something or accepting something just because somebody else says so. So continuing about my experiences with longer fasting, like more than 5, 6 days, what I found was that typically my hunger or the feelings of hunger would go away after about 2 days. So actually, like 3rd day onwards would be easier. During these fasts, I also like worked. I cooked for my husband. I would work, so I've done these fasts while working. And typically, I've had a pretty good energy on most of these fasts for like all the 6, 7, 8 that I've done those. Most of the side effects are what they call the healing crisis that people experience during fasting. One of the bigger ones that I felt is just digestive discomfort or just like feeling a little bit of gassiness or bloating, a little bit of like nausea. So my water fasts are a little bit, I guess I give myself the freedom to have things like ginger tea or lemon ginger tea, or ajwain or something like that to help with that digestive discomfort. Sometimes I've felt a little bit of a backache or a headache, but not a whole lot. Definitely my body is much cooler. My feet especially become very cold, so on days that I'm fasting, I will probably put on socks. Even in the middle of summer, I will use a heating pad to keep my feet warm at night. I have also noticed that once or twice that if I get up too quickly, there is a little bit of a dizziness, and that is typically from the blood sugar stabilizing to a lower value, the body slowing down, and the blood pressure also going down. And the simple solution to that is to just not do that, and if you feel a little bit of dizziness, just stand there or just sit down, like not move at all. And if I'm in a place where I can put my head down, just do that. So, I mean, I've not had any problems as such with that. The other symptoms that I have had, or the symptoms or side effects, have just been like the tongue gets coated with the white fuzzy thing, and even after I've brushed twice a day, even longer, like the tongue feels coated a lot, which is also a sign of detoxification. The other practice that I have usually done with these longer fasts is use enemas, do enemas. Except for the first one that I did, where I did salt water flushing, I found enemas to be easier, which helps clean not only the colon, but I think just helps the body flush out all the toxins that it is so diligently working on removing and cleansing. So I've done typically once a day or once in 2 days. Sometimes I've also done twice a day in the beginning of a fast, but that I did at the earlier fast. But I think now, having done five, six of these longer fasts over the last 10, 12 years, I now find that like enema once a day or once every other day is okay for me, and I guess everybody would have to decide that for themselves. So, this I guess has been my experience with fasting, and I do want to do like a longer fast, like an 8 day or a 10 day, maybe even a 14 day fast, just for healing the body and helping it heal itself, helping it regenerate. Sometime in 2021, since the COVID pandemic, I did not want to do a longer fast because I did not want to take the risk that there probably would be a period where the immunity would go down, and so I did not want to take any chances while COVID was going on, and I was unvaccinated. Now that I have both the doses of the vaccine, that is something I am thinking of doing. I haven't s exactly set any dates for that. But if I do that, I would definitely try and make a video log of that as well. So that's it for today's video. So I just wanted to share my experiences with fasting, how I believe in fasting. I definitely think it works well. There is a lot of fasting that I've seen people do in my family, so it feels very natural to me. I have personally done these several day fasts, and I know that I have actually felt really energized on most days of those fasts. So one of the things that made an impression for me that she wrote, Dr. Isabel Mosier, was that it is easier to fast when you're healthy than when you're sick. So that is the other reason I have done this fasting, is just so that I can build up the skill of fasting. Anyway, so I think that's my video for today. I am going to maybe talk about my experiences with intermittent fasting and weight loss in one of the next videos over the next few days. And that's it for today. Bye.